There are challenging times to be a person of faith, and Joe Boland of the Catholic Extension joins us to talk about a great new initiative called Why I'm Catholic. Joe, thanks for being with us. How are you doing today?
Thank you. I'm doing wonderful.
Hey, can you tell viewers who may not be familiar with Catholic Extension a bit about your mission and what you do?
Sure. So Catholic Extension is a papal mission society. We've actually been around since 1905, and since that time we've had one mission, and that is to help strengthen the presence of the Catholic Church throughout the country, particularly in some of the poorest regions of the United States. And so we've got a wonderful legacy, and our wonderful claim to fame is that we've helped build and repair more churches in the United States than there are Dunkin' Donut shops in the United States.
Wow.
So we've done an incredible amount of work, and the work continues, and the mission continues till today.
And now you have to drop the donuts after that, Joe, because they changed their name.
Just Dunkin's.
I told my kids that. They're not ready to accept donuts being dropped off the name.
Now, let's say if we could get right into the this newly launched campaign inviting Catholics everywhere to share their stories using the hashtag Why I'm Catholic. Can you tell us about that, and why are you doing this?
Yeah. Well, as you mentioned, we're in very difficult times for the church, very sad times, and sadly, very divisive times as well. And so we at Catholic Extension, in the work that we do, wanted to create a vehicle, a mechanism, if you will, to help bring Catholics together around what is a very important question, but also a very important answer, and that is why I'm Catholic. And so we created this hashtag, Why I'm Catholic initiative, that we've simply put on our website, we put on our social media channels. About 100,000 people have seen it so far. Many people from even across the globe have participated. And they're all chiming in about the different ways in which the church has touched their life, in which faith matters, and how this thing we call Catholicism is so very important to them. And it's essentially a way that we can offer encouragement to the rest of us, faithful Catholics, who need this shot of encouragement in these very difficult times.
Okay, so Joe, can you give us an example of why you feel this reason to be so hopeful, though, for the Catholic Church in America? Because you're right, it has been tough. I think for all of us who are Catholics, it hurts. I mean, it just hurts, because we know the beauty of the church, and of course, our focus should always be on that Eucharist.
Yeah. Well, I'm very fortunate in my work, because we are a national organization. We get to work with some of the greatest expressions of church around the country. And we see the church at its best. And I'm thinking most recently of an example. We do a lot of work in the Diocese of Brownsville, which is in the very south tip of the state of Texas, mm-hmm. South Texas. And the church is growing by leaps and bounds. The average age of a Catholic there is 26 years old. And the bishop can't build churches fast enough. In fact, Catholic Extension, he has told us, needs to help him build at least 3 to 4 new churches every year just to keep up with the pace of growth. And I was down there a couple of months ago, and I was visiting a church, the latest church that the bishop is asking us to help build down there. It's in a very poor community. It's going to serve thousands of people. The structure's relatively simple, but I walked inside the church, and what do I see are these magnificent stained glass windows. And the priest told me that those windows had been from a church in Boston, which had recently been shuttered. And they wanted to make sure, this Boston church, that it went to a place where the faithful could continue to enjoy them and pray with them. And so in this very simple structure, you have these magnificent windows that are going to benefit the faithful. And it was just, to me, a wonderful example of how when there's death or a dying off in a certain part of the church, there's always new life somewhere else. The church is always being reborn, and I really believe that that's what we're going to continue to see in the months and in the years ahead, that wherever there's something dying away, there's new life being born. And fortunately, we see that all over the country at Catholic Extension, and it's something that we want to remind everyone around the country, is that the church has strength in many far-flung areas of the country, And we need to remember that, that God continues to be with us and that faith matters in people's lives.
It absolutely does, Joe. You know, from all you're saying, it's refreshing. How can people help out, and where can they learn more about Catholic Extension?
Well, they can simply go to our website, which is catholicextension.org. There we have this whole Why Catholic initiative there for them. And they can read about these very encouraging stories about people saying, speaking from their heart about why Catholicism matters. And so often, as I've been scrolling through many of these responses, one thing has really stood out to me, and that is that people are saying, this is my identity. This is who I am. Faith is like oxygen to me, and I could no more give up my Catholic faith than I could give up my ethnic heritage. It's that close to who they are and to their identity. And so just for me personally, it's been a great encouragement to me, and I would encourage anybody else to go and visit that website to read what everyone else is saying about their Catholic faith.
Well, our faith is certainly a fabric of our life. Joe, thanks so much for being with us today and all the great work you do. We appreciate you taking the time.
Thank you so much. Have a